a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered what is indexing in NumPy arrays, how does indexing work in NumPy arrays. We have done indexing in 2D, 3D and 1D arrays as well. So in our today's session, we'll be talking about iteration in NumPy arrays. That means how we can iterate and obtain one value in each line using the for loop over here. So for iterating NumPy arrays, first of all, we will be importing NumPy, import NumPy as np. After we have imported NumPy as np, we will be creating an array over here. For that, I'll be writing arr is equals to np.array. And once I have created an array, I'll be passing a list inside it. So we can pass a list. Okay, this is my list, let's say. And if I want to print it, suppose if I directly print it like this, if I write print arr, in that way I will only obtain what, 1, 2, 6, 3, 8 in the format of an array over here. But if I want to fetch each element here, in that case what I can do, I can write a for loop that for I in arr colon print I. Now once if I run it, what I'll be getting, I'll be getting each element inside each different line. This is because of our for loop. Now this is about one dimension. What if it was two dimensions? Suppose if I would have added one more array over here, and let's make it two dimensional. So now if I run it, in that case it would form a pair for me, like 1 2 6 3 8 and 5 1 6 8 2. In this way we will obtain two arrays. But I want to obtain each element in each different line of both the arrays. In that case what I'll do, I'll be using the concept of nested loops over here. If you remember, we have learned about nested loops before in our Python, and similarly the nested loop work over here, that for we will be writing for I in arr. And now inside this I, so the I is giving us 1 2 6 3 8, and inside this we need to iterate. So for that I'll be writing for j in I. So we do not have to go in the array now. We need to go inside the I, because I is giving us these elements. So we'll be going inside the I and we will be printing j. So let's run and see what output we will receive now. So as soon as I run it, I'll be getting the output in this way. We have 1, 2, 6, 3, 8, 5, 1, 6, 8, 2 in each different line. This is how iteration is working with the 2D arrays. But what if it is a 3D array? So first of all, let's make it a 3D array. So I've converted this into a 3D array, and if I run it right now with the same previous code, I'll be getting a pairs in this way, 1, 2, 3, 8, 5, 1, 8, 2. Now I need to go inside these J's as well. To go inside these J's, what I'll be doing, I'll be writing for, let's say K in J. We will be printing K this time. So we'll be print K. And I'll just remove this line. Now let's run and see what output we'll get. So this time now again we are getting the output in the format of each. So now this time again we are getting the output, and it's in each different line. So we have 1, 2, 3, 8, 5, 1, 8, 2, which is there in here. 1, 2, 3, 8, 5, 1, 8, 2. So this is how you can do it. But now what if the dimensions keeps increasing over here? So what you will do, you will keep increasing the for loop. No, that would be a lot of a task, right? So to avoid that to happen, we have n dimensional iteration method. For that, what I'll be doing, let me just put control Z and put all of this inside the comment. So you will see the difference that for iterating this, we wrote this four lines of code. And now what I'm going to do next is for I in np dot nd iter. So nd iter is a function, nd iterator. Nd means n dimensional iterator. And here inside it, we will be passing arr, which is the name of our array. And we will print I. So if I run it, we will now notice that we will be obtaining the same output which we were getting using the nested loops. All we need to do over here is write for I in, but this time we will be iterating inside the AR by using the n dimensional iterator function over here, and we will simply print I. So we'll get the output within two lines instead of getting it with the four lines. And you can get any dimensions, any number of dimensions now. Even if I put one dimensional array over here, for example, I'll just copy this and write something like this. And if I run it, I would still get what, the same output, that is 357269. So doesn't matter what is the dimension over here. If I'm using n dimensional iterator, it will automatically go inside the arrays and get the each element inside each line. So just like how we can use nd iteration for iterating the arrays, here we can use enumerate method as well. Now what does enumerate method do over here is very simple. It will give you, it will iterate all the values for you along with the indexes. That means we can get the indexes as well over here in front of the elements. For example, on number 0 we have 3, on number 1 we have 5, on number 2 we have 7, on number 3 we have 2, on number 4 we have 6, and lastly on number 5 we have 9. So for that, all we need to do is write for index. So we need to obtain index plus we need to obtain the value. So for index comma I in np dot enumerate, so n dimensional enumerate arr, we will be passing inside it. And we will print, instead of printing just I, we will be printing ind and I. It's not end, it should be ind. So ind and I. Now let's run and see what output we will receive. So as soon as I'll run it, you can see on number 0 index, we have 3. Number 1 index, we have 5. Number 2, we have 7. Number 3, we have 2. And number 4, we have 6. And lastly, on number 5, we have 9. So this is how our nd enumerate method over here works. So nd over here is n dimensional enumerate. Similarly, if I would have written it in this way, that I would have closed a bracket here, another bracket I would have opened here, and I would have made it two-dimensional. In that case, if I run it again, I'll be getting the output. So we have received the output in the format of 003. Now what is 00 over here? 0 over here is this array, and inside it we are going to 0th element, that is number 3. Again, we are talking about the 0th array, and here we are going inside the first element, that is number 5, and then second element would be 7. Now next we will be going to our next array. The next array would be on number 1. Inside this we will be going to our 0 element, that is number 2. Then we will be going on our first element, that is number 6. And lastly we will be going on our second element, that is number 9. So this is how we can go for the n dimensions. That's why it says over here n dimensional enumerate. That means you can iterate up to n dimensions over here. And similarly, if I do the same for the 3-dimensional array, suppose if I'll create a 3-dimensional array over here, so I'll put a comma and write some values, and I'll put the whole inside as pair of square brackets. Now if I run it, I'll get the output in this way. So we have on 000, that means if I talk about this one, so it's inside the 0th array. Inside this again we have a 0 and 1 array. And inside this also we have on inside the 0th array as well, we have the 0 element, that is R3. Then 001 would be 5, 002 would be 7. Again 010 means this whole array is on number 0. Inside this on number 1 we have this array, and inside this on 0 element we have number 2. Similarly on 1 element we have 6, and the next element would be 9, and it keeps going on up to the end. So I hope guys that all the three methods of iteration over here are clear to you, that how you can use for loop along with the nested loop, how you can use the nd iteration, and how you can use the nd enumerate method as well. In our next session, we'll be talking about the copy versus view functions in our NumPy arrays. So stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.